Hello, Sumalata Baina Cakes. This I am Sumalata, English Assistant GMS High School, Athipeta. Today we are going to learn about pronouns. We already learned what is pronoun. Pronouns are usually used instead of nouns. Many types are there in pronouns. There are 8 types of pronouns. What are they? One is personal pronoun. These are I, you, we, he, she, it, and they. They replace nouns representing people, places, and things. They replaces nouns representing people, places, and things. These are personal pronouns. These are used instead of names of places, persons and things. These are of 3 types. First person pronouns. I, we. I is for singular. We is used for plural. Second person pronouns. You. You is used for both singular and for plural. Third person. He, she, it. These 3 are used for singular. And they are is used for plural pronoun. These are all subjective pronouns. That means these are used in the place of subject. There are also objective pronouns. Those are given in the pronoun chart already. For I, me. For we, us. For you, you only. For he, him. For she, her. For it. For they, them. These are all called objective pronouns. One is personal pronoun. These are I, you, we, he, she, it, and they. They replace nouns representing people, places, and things. They replaces nouns representing people, places and things. These are personal pronouns. These are used instead of names of places, persons and things. These are of 3 types. First person pronouns. I, we. I is for singular. We is used for plural. Second person pronouns. You. You is used for both singular and for plural. Third person, he, she, it. These 3 are used for singular and they are is used for plural pronoun. These are all subjective pronouns. That means these are used in the place of subject. There are also objective pronouns. Those are given in the pronoun chart already. For I, me. For we, us. For you, you only. For he, him. For she, her. For it. For they, them. These are all called objective pronouns. Demonstrative pronoun. They are used to demonstrate or indicate. These are used for demonstrating or indicating. Example, this, that, these, those. These are called demonstrative pronouns. Interrogative pronouns. Interrogative pronoun is a function word used to ask a question. That is what, who, where. These are all interrogative pronouns. It is a function word used to ask a question. These are used in direct questions and also in indirect questions. Used in direct questions and also in indirect questions. Interrogative pronouns. Interrogative pronoun is a function word used to ask a question. That is what, who, where. These are all interrogative pronouns. It is a function word used to ask a question. These are used in direct questions and also in indirect questions. Used in direct questions and also in indirect questions. Possessive pronouns. It is a word that replaces a noun and shows ownership. Example, my, mine, his. These replaces a noun and shows ownership. My pencil, my pen, his book, your book, your house. These are the examples of possessive pronouns. These are important to write active passive voice and also directed speech. In any grammar, we should learn compulsorily these possessive pronouns, personal pronouns, subjective pronouns and also objective pronouns. Next, relative pronouns. It is a pronoun that has an adjective. Example, which, who, whose. It is a pronoun that has an adjective. I already told that a disabled man, who refers to disabled man. Agra, which is referring to Agra. In this way we use relative pronouns. Reflexive or emphatic pronoun. Example, myself, herself, etc. Reflexive pronoun or emphatic pronoun. Example, myself, herself, etc. I do this work myself. She is driving the car herself. In this way, we use this reflexive or emphatic pronouns. Next one, reciprocal pronouns. It is used to express a mutual action or relationship. That example, each other, one another, etc. Reciprocal pronouns. It is used to express a mutual action or relationship. Each other, one another, etc.